Poem, The Solitary Reaper. Behold her single in the field, yon solitary highland lass, reaping and singing by herself. Stop here or gently pass. Alone she cuts and binds the grain and sings a melancholy strain. Oh, listen, for the veil profound is overflowing with the sound. Behold her single in the field and solitary island lass, reaping and singing by herself. Stop here or gently pass. Alone she cuts and binds the grain and sings a melancholy strain. Oh, listen, for the veil profound is overflowing with the sound. No nightingale did ever chant more welcome notes to weary bands of travelers in some shady haunt among Arabian sands. A voice so thrilling never was heard in springtime from the cuckoo bird, breaking the silence of the seas among the farthest Hebrides. No nightingale did ever chant more welcome notes to weary bands of travelers in some shady haunt among Arabian sands. A voice so thrilling never was heard in springtime from the cuckoo bird, breaking the silence of the seas among the farthest Hebrides. Will no one tell me what she sings? Perhaps the plaintive numbers flow for old, unhappy, far off things and battles long ago. Or is it some more humble lay, familiar matter of today? Some natural sorrow, loss, or pain that has been and may be again. Will no one tell me what she sings? Perhaps the plaintive numbers flow for old, unhappy, far off things and the battles long ago. Or is it some more humble lay, familiar matter of today, some natural sorrow, loss, or pain that has been and may be again? Whatever the theme, the maiden sang, as if her song could have no ending. I saw her singing at her work and over the sickle bending. I listened motionless and still, and as I mounted up the hill, the music in my heart I bore, long after it was heard no more. Whatever the theme the maiden sang, as if her song could have no ending, I saw her singing at her work and over the sickle bending. I listened motionless and still, and as I mounted up the hill, the music in my heart I bore, long after it was heard no more. William Wordsworth.